Maybe it's a little bit different than what you're used to, but in the molecular orbital model, no single orbital can be equated to a particular bond. We're going to see that in the molecule methane, where we'll work out some of the molecular orbitals that are produced from the LCAO method. Here's our point of reference. It's a tetrahedron methane molecule. Our coordinate system X, Y, and Z is shown there. And so the carbon atom contributes four atomic orbitals, a 2s orbital, and then the 2p, x, y, and z. Each of the hydrogen atoms contribute one 1s orbital, and so there's a total of eight atomic orbitals altogether that will produce eight molecular orbitals. Here we're only going to construct the four that are occupied. Let's start with the lowest energy case. This is a molecular orbital that has zero nodes. It results from a linear combination of the 2s orbital centered on carbon that constructively interferes with the 1s orbitals that are centered on each of the corners from the hydrogen atoms. The phases match, that's why there's constructive interference. There is no nodes at all, and so we have the lowest energy case for the first molecular orbital. The next three molecular orbitals are equal in energy, and they all have one node. They're all derived from a 2p orbital that's centered on carbon, and the 2p is either oriented along the z, the y, or the x direction. Let's take a look at one example. It's easiest perhaps to see in the 2pz. The bottom lobe has a shaded lobe on the carbon atom, and so you can see that we have added the correct shading for constructive interference from the two hydrogen atoms that will overlap with that lobe. Similarly, the top is unshaded, and so we've matched the phases for those hydrogen atoms to the phase where there's going to be constructive overlap, constructive interference with that top lobe of the 2pz orbital. Now you can probably very clearly see that the nodal plane that exists in this molecular orbital cuts right through the center of this cube, right where that 2pz changes sign. You can do the same thing for the 2py and the 2px, and the result is that we have three molecular orbitals, each of which will be occupied, and each of which has one node. Chemists invented the concept of hybridization because of this idea that they couldn't pinpoint exactly what bond these molecular orbitals correspond to. But we really don't need the concept of hybridization. Everything is completely contained in the molecular orbitals. Hybridization is a convenient concept to think about how we can reconcile the molecular orbital bonding picture and the valence bonding picture. And if you'd like to remind yourself about what those hybrid orbitals look like, you can take a look at this ChemTube 3D site. But hybridization is an extra concept, and we won't use it unless there's a particular reason to. In the next webcast, we'll introduce some approximate language to speak about localized bonding in the molecular orbital picture. But before we go there, check out this Darmstadt site that's linked to your notes. There's some fascinating interactive graphics that show the molecular orbitals of methane.